This is really very encouraging, I have to tell you. This tells us we're going to win. We're going to win Florida. This enthusiasm is, my goodness, I've been through four or five presidential campaigns. I've never, ever seen enthusiasm like the enthusiasm you have for Donald Trump. Never, never. There's something very special going on here, a movement that's going on here that the media doesn't quite pick up. They never did, going back 18 months ago. They never understood it. They've never seen it, but I can feel that emotion. I can feel that strength. You're looking forward to November 8th and making a big change in the direction of our government. And you know you have the right man to do it. Because in order to make the kind of change, you need a strong man, you need an independent man, you need a man who tells it straight. Sometimes really straight. But boy, it's a heck of a lot better than being a liar. So, what do you think of all these emails that are now coming out? Don't they prove to us that what we always thought about her was true? Now it's in writing, right? So all those conspiracy theories turn out to be correct. Well, here's one email, just one. This is a speech that she gave in 2013. She says that she has both a public and private position on public policy. So she has one position when she's being paid $225,000 for a speech. That one costs $225,000. And then she's got a different position when she comes out and talks to you. You see, what I call that is a liar. Then she was paid another $225,000 for a speech in which she said she wants open trade and open borders. Open borders. I have news for you, Hillary. A country with open borders is not a country. And we're living in an age of tremendous danger. ISIS has told us they're going to send people to Europe and America to come and kill us. And she wants open borders. She won't say that. She won't say that. That's the private one. The public one is, I'm going to control the borders. The private one is open borders. I don't know. You pick. All I can say is it equals being a liar. Third, in a speech that she gave, this time she got a little more money for $262,500. This money is adding up now, right? Chink, 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 chink. All going into the pocket, boom, boom. So this one, she said, she wants universal health coverage like you have in Canada. How many of you have ever gone to Canada for health treatment? You know what it's like? It's terrible, right? You stand online and then you die because they get to you in 6 months. We want our health system. People come from Canada to America for health care. They don't go to Canada for health care from America. Hillary, we don't want your socialized medicine. Take it and stuff it. I didn't say it. I suggested it, but I didn't say it. Here's another great one. This one, we don't know how much money she got paid for, but it might tell you why she doesn't like us. She says that she is, oh, she actually said this to Goldman Sachs, which is the richest and biggest financial institution in the world that is giving her millions, if not hundreds of millions of dollars. You think they're doing it for nothing? You think they're doing it because they're not going to get anything in return? You think they got that rich being stupid? You think they own her? You're darn right they own her like this. She doesn't belong to you. She belongs to all these people who are paying her this money. So here's what she told Goldman Sachs. She was far removed from the struggles of the middle class because of her and Bill's fortunes. She's far removed from all of you. By the way, half of you that support Donald Trump are deplorables. Do you know that? There you go. You are a deplorable. You're deplorable. Not only that, you're irredeemable. I don't know, even Jesus can't help you. I thought Jesus said we all could be redeemed. According to Hillary, you are irredeemable. Oh, by the way, she and the people around her don't much like Catholics or evangelicals either. They're all stupid. If you're a Catholic or an evangelical, you're stupid, according to her staff and the people around her. And you know she doesn't really care about the rights of freedom of religion. You know that because she never defends them. And she thinks she's intellectually superior to all of us who might be Catholics or evangelicals. Well, if you ever want to know if she really believes it, go look what's written down on paper. During a 2013-page speech, for which she got $225,000, she told the very rich audience that she was speaking to that terrorism was not a threat to us. Go tell that to the people of San Bernardino, Hillary. Go tell that to the people of Orlando. And don't tell me, if you said that you remember September 11, 2001. I remember September 11, 2001. Yes. Yes, you helped to get benefits for the people that were injured that day. But I heard her say one day she was there that day. I was there that day. I don't remember seeing Hillary Clinton there. That was like when she said she had a run through gunfire. That turned out to be, what do we call it? A lie. But don't tell me you subscribe to the notion that all of us who lived through September 11 and were lucky to be alive and have lost so many friends. I lost so many friends on September 11. I think about it every day. Don't tell me you belong to our very, very tight group of never forget. Don't tell me that. If for money, you go tell people that terrorism is not a threat to our nation. We've had more terrorist attacks in the last 10 months than at any time since September 11. And that becomes about because I believe this administration, Obama, Clinton, Kerry, they show weakness time and time and time again. And I will tell you this, the best way to encourage radical Islamic terrorism is to show weakness. They will keep hitting you until you hit them back harder and drive them back. We used to be on offense, we're now on defense. And we need someone who can change that. We need someone who can put America on offense, who can say the words radical Islamic terrorism. We need someone who can bring jobs back, lower taxes. We need someone who can straighten out our economy and our trade deals. And we need someone that can make Americans proud again to be American, and that's Donald J. Trump. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. This is a big, big crowd. You know, I'll tell you the sad thing, however. The only people that will be shown on television won't be the 15,000 people. It'll be this group right over here. So the good news is you have better seats, or standing room only, but you have better. But they're going to be more famous, right? They're going to be more famous. Look, we want to have the cameras circle around and show this crowd. Would you do that? Cameras. Go ahead, cameras. They never do it. They never do it, so we won't waste our time. It's just the dishonest media. Look. We love being here. I love being with you. I love this state. As you know, I'm here all the time. In 27 days, we're going to win Florida, and we're going to win back the White House. And that's what's happening, folks. That's what's happening. We're going to bring back our jobs. We're going to end illegal immigration. We're going to renegotiate our totally disastrous, these deals, the trade deals, the worst. We're going to renegotiate those trade deals. Reduce surging crime. You saw what happened the other day. Murders in the United States, the highest level in 45 years. You don't hear that from the press. We're going to cut taxes, big league. Crooked Hillary is going to raise taxes. We're going to cut taxes and regulations. We're going to reduce the cost of education. By the way, we're going to end Common Core, and we're bringing our education local. We're going to lift the restrictions on American energy and deliver real change for our great American people. It's time. And when it comes to international government, to massive trade deals, and to America's borders, we're going to defend the freedom and sovereignty of the United States of America like never before. And we are going to once again put America first. The deadline for voter register. Who is not registered? Is there anybody in here not registered? If you're not registered, get the hell out of here, okay? This is a nice-looking young guy. Hey, listen, leave right now and go and register. They just extended it for a little while, so right after, raise your right hand. Do you promise you're going to register after this? If you like what I say, okay? If you like what I say.
Seriously, I'm curious. Who is not registered in this room? Okay, all young people. And believe me, the young people like me better than Bernie, I'm telling you. Because with me, when you graduate from college, you're going to come out and you're going to have a vast array of jobs, okay, right? So go out and register, and we're going to have an awfully big, I'll tell you what, honestly, we're going to have a big 4 years, 8 years, we're going to have a big, great future for our country. Also, you could request an absentee ballot, and you can vote by mail if necessary. So register, request a ballot. Thank you. I love you. I love you too. The Hillary Clinton documents, have you been seeing this, what's going on? Released by WikiLeaks, make more clear than ever just how much is at stake in November and how unattractive and dishonest our country has become. The election of Hillary Clinton would lead, in my opinion, to the almost total destruction of our country as we know it. She would be the most dishonest and the most corrupt person ever elected to high office, and I don't think it would be close. The WikiLeaks emails show the Department of Justice fed information, did you see this? To the Clinton campaign. So think of this. The Department of Justice, you remember that whole deal with Wild Bill getting on the back of an airplane, just happened to be in Arizona, he was gonna play golf, it was 110 degrees. But he gets on the back of the airplane to meet with the Attorney General to talk about his golf game and to talk about his grandkids. He was there for 39 minutes. I think most of us know what happened. So fed information, the Department of Justice fed information, think of this, to the Clinton campaign about the email investigation so that the campaign could be prepared to cover up her crimes. Now, did you ever hear anything like this? And by the way, these dishonest people, mainstream media, they don't talk about this. They don't talk about this. Now, if I sneeze, if Donald Trump sneezes today, it's a major story. Here you have Department of Justice coming to see them to brief them prior to their interview. Folks, this is out of control. And the FBI, unbelievable people, you have incredible people in the FBI. I would be willing to bet that they are so ashamed of what's happened at the upper level. I would be willing to bet that they don't even sleep at night. These are great people, these are great Americans, and they can't believe what's going on. This corruption and collusion is just one more reason why I will ask my Attorney General to appoint a special prosecutor. Our country has never been so low. In addition to a special prosecutor to look into what happened and all of the corruption and all of the, we'll say so-called crime, but look, when somebody deletes 33,000 emails after getting a subpoena, but we have to also remember this, this is maybe in a sense even more important. We have to investigate the investigation. We have to investigate the investigation. We've never had a case like this. And even Congress, you know, is sort of, they've never had this before. because there's no event like this that ever took place. Normally Congress, you know, she lied to Congress. She lied to the FBI. And remember, he said she was negligent. She was all the things you needed to be. But she lied to Congress. She lied to the FBI. She lied to everybody. She even lied in the debates about the gold standard, right? Remember, she said, I never said gold standard. And remember when I said lying in the sand, she said, I wasn't Secretary of State. I said, I think you were, but let's see. Even the press said she was Secretary of State, so she lied about that. But think of this. Think of this. There's never been a time like this in our country. And Congress, in all fairness, and I'm so disappointed in them. I am so disappointed in Congress. I am so disappointed. And I mean both sides. I'm not talking Republican, Dem. I'm talking everybody. To allow a thing like this to go on, this is crime at the highest level. She shouldn't be allowed to run for president. You know that. Other people's lives have been ruined, destroyed, for doing a tiny fraction of what she did. You saw the man with a book, he had to give back all the royalties and went through hell. You saw the man with a picture of the submarine, his mother goes around, she's devastated, devastated. Took pictures of a submarine. And you take a look at this. So we have to investigate the investigation, and Congress, and I speak to congressmen, they don't know what to do, because normally they vote and they hand it over to the FBI and the Justice Department. But the FBI and the Justice Department won't do anything. So they don't know what to do. Now they do make laws. Maybe they have to make up a law for a case like this. But they take these criminal acts, in my opinion, criminal acts, hand them over to the FBI. The FBI actually acknowledged that even, frankly, could have gone, that speech could have been 10 times longer. But all of these things, yes, she did this, yes, she did this, yes, she did that, yes, she did that, but we're not going to do anything, right? But what do you do when you hand them over to the FBI and the Justice Department, and that's the end of it? We have never been in a position like this. I'm so embarrassed by what's taken place, and I'm very, very disappointed in Congress, because our people, our politicians, I don't know, do they make a deal where everybody protects each other in Washington? Maybe that's it. I really believe it. I really believe it. I almost say, listen, we're going to leave you alone, but when it's our turn, you have to leave them alone. Do they make deals like this? This is the most heinous, the most serious thing that I've ever seen involving justice in the United States, in the history of the United States. We have a person that has committed crimes that is now running for the presidency, and she has a Justice Department where she essentially told the AG in a speech or a talk that she'd appoint her AG again. And this is the person that's supposed to be ruling. Folks, whether I win, lose, or draw, I'm ashamed of what's happened to our country, and so are you. Hillary Clinton bleached and deleted 33,000 emails. And did you see 2 days ago, boxes of emails and other things were missing? They were missing. So she deleted 33,000 emails and bleached them. By the way, nobody bleaches. Nobody. I have people that are sophisticated in this world. They never even heard of it. They called it acid washed, meaning you can never retrieve them. Although I have a feeling that the NSA has them. They don't want them. They don't want to get them. I have a feeling. So then she did this after, not before. Before it would be bad. She did this after getting a congressional subpoena. Now, if your friend is suing you in a regular lawsuit, and you do that, you go to jail. Here's the United States Congress, subpoenas her emails and other things, and she deletes the emails saying that 33,000 emails, remember? for the wedding and for yoga classes, $33,000. And then, after all of that, now they're missing two boxes of perhaps the most important of the group. And what about a law firm? You know what? She's using a phenomenal law firm. I know the firm. Phenomenal law firm. They're the ones that did all this stuff. Remember, they said, we made a ruling they were work-related. You can't do that. If they're work-related, what you do is you show them. You show them and you get them. The law firm, nobody ever mentions. The law firm is unbelievable. It's very powerful. Okay? Obviously, they've done a great job. But that law firm should be implicated in this crime. Okay? They're the ones, they got rid of all this stuff. The law firm got rid of all this stuff, and they should be implicated because they have committed a crime. They are not supposed to say, oh, we got rid of most of it. That law firm that I know very well, as I said, total professionals, total insiders, they got rid of 33,000 and much more than that. It is one of the great miscarriages of justice. So then she destroyed her phones, some with a hammer, to cover up her crimes. Now, how many of you people have gotten rid of cell phones and you start whacking them with a hammer? Has any, please raise your hand, please. One, what business are you in? I see two hands, we have 15,000. Two hands. Anybody else? It is so disgraceful, it's so embarrassing. And by the way, we're gonna go over some of the WikiLeaks stuff. The press hardly reports it. They hardly report it. She did a big number on Catholics, horrible number on Catholics. She did a horrible number on evangelicals through her people, and they hardly report it. While she was Secretary of State, she lost or disappeared almost $6 billion. Does anyone know that? No. How do you lose $6 billion? Even Chelsea Clinton, in the WikiLeaks emails where it shows, expressed, quote, serious concerns about conflicts of interest at the Clinton Foundation and the State Department. Americans have had it with the years and decades of Clinton corruption. It's corruption. Whitewater. Tattle. Never ends with these people. Remember years ago, most of you are too young to remember. Remember the cattle? She bought some cattle and she had the greatest return, like almost in the history of cattle deals. And some of these professional cattlemen and cattle women, they said, boy, she's really good at this stuff. They've been doing all their lives. They had never had a return like that. It's corruption, folks. It's corruption. They understood that, by the way. They're smart. They got it very quickly. This will finally be the year the American people say enough is enough. During a recent trip to Florida, I had a chance to spend some time with the incredible residents of Little Haiti. And you see what's going on in Haiti. It's a horrible thing. And you see what's going on with Clinton. It's a horrible thing. These are not fans of Clinton, that I can tell you. They despise the Clintons for what they did to the Haitian people. New emails revealed by ABC News just yesterday show that during the deadly earthquake in Haiti, which killed over 150,000 people, the Clintons couldn't stop cashing in. They kept cashing in. As people were dying in Haiti, Clinton insiders were separating out requests from friends of Bill or William Jefferson Clinton VIPs so that their business interests or contracts would receive very special treatment, while those who were not special friends would be put permanently on the sidelines. And remember this, Hillary's brother running a gold mine, put on the gold, Tony, you saw Tony, Tony. Anybody want to hire Tony? He's put on the board of a big gold mine company having to do with Haiti. It's so bad. Look, we're in a rigged system, folks. This is a rigged system. You saw it. You saw so many of the things. I'll tell you, this WikiLeaks stuff is unbelievable. It tells you the inner heart. You got to read it. And you got to maybe get it because they're not putting it out. They want to put it out, but they can't do that because without the media and without the press, Hillary Clinton would be nothing. She'd be nothing. Zero. And by the way, did everybody see the debate the other day? Yes, right? So they had 9 online polls. Some of them had us 90 to 10, 80 to 20. Time magazine had like a massive, look, Time magazine is no friend of mine, except they put me in the cover so much. Not because they like me, because they like selling magazines. But Time magazine, it was total destruction. And then the next morning she walks in and says, did everybody see the debate? The people go, yeah, sure. Did we beat her or what? I look so forward. I look so forward to the next one in Las Vegas. As Haiti's death toll from Hurricane Matthew is on the rise, we should never forget how Bill and Hillary Clinton handled Haiti the last time. To all our friends in Little Haiti, the great people, I mean, I spent a long time. These are people that are incredible. They have the warmest feeling, the warmest heart. But to all of our friends in Little Haiti, your day of justice is coming, believe me. And it arrives on November 8th. November 8th. Get out and vote. November 8th. The new emails also show members of the Clinton team viciously attacking Catholics and evangelicals. They attack Catholics and evangelicals. Viciously. And that won't be tolerated, but it won't be tolerated by the voters. Tell you what, anybody of religion, I really think you have to vote for Donald Trump, to be honest with you. I really do believe that. And in all of the primaries, you saw that. I wasn't expected to win with the evangelicals, but once we got started and once they heard my message as opposed to other people's messages, we won big with evangelicals. They're incredible people. And remember the Johnson Amendment. We're going to get rid of that Johnson Amendment. Just remember that. These emails are just the latest evidence of the hatred that the Clinton campaign has for everyday faithful Americans. True. The WikiLeaks emails show that Hillary Clinton's staff even has to give her secret notes on when she needs to smile. Smile, Hillary, smile. Hey, folks, we have to get back to work. Our country's in trouble. We can't play games anymore. Smile. You believe it? Smile. And how about where it said, to the public you say this, but to the others that give you the money you say that. I'll tell you, it's so revealing. Somebody's going to do a great book on that because the press just are not little tiny stories, big things. Getting answers for debates and questions for debates before the debate takes place. How about that? I'll tell you what. Can you imagine me if any of this stuff pertained to me? Front page headlines all over the world. Donald Trump. Oh, well, we've been there and we seem to be doing very well. Hillary Clinton, commonly referred to as Crooked Hillary, thinks that you, all of you, are deplorable and totally irredeemable. I actually think irredeemable is worse. I don't know. I'm the only one. Deplorable and irredeemable. Irredeemable meaning you can never, ever come back. I call you hardworking American patriots, and together we are going to save this country and we are going to make America great again. And it's hot as hell in here, but I don't care. It's called Florida, right? Florida. The emails also show that the DNC vice chair was feeding information, so much information, to the candidate. Oh, man, I want that. Why can't the Republicans do that? Why can't Reince feed me information prior to a debate? I'm so angry at the Republicans. I want to be fed information like Hillary gets. And we still beat her badly, right? So, I mean, what's the big deal? But I want information. The Republicans are not doing their job. They should be able to get me all of the questions prior to the debate. This all comes after a secret tape that shows Hillary Clinton calling Bernie voters. Now, look, Bernie is, I feel sorry for Bernie. He made a deal with the devil, and he blew his reputation. But she called Bernie voters basement dwellers. To all of the Bernie voters out there, join our movement, like all of these young people. We're going to fix our trade deals and get special interests out of government. And by the way, by the time this ends, I'll have over $100 million of my money in this thing, right? Which means that's $100 million of people that don't have to give me money and say, Donald, will you do this? Will you do that? Will you do that? It's a lot of money. And I asked her the other night, I said, you know, I'll have over $100 million in. It's a lot of money. If I lose, I'm going to be so angry at Florida. Oh. I'll still love you, I think. Maybe not. You know, one of the pundits said, and you've heard me say this maybe, but they said, Mr. Trump, doesn't matter whether you win or lose. You have done the single greatest job. Nobody's ever done a thing like this before. No matter where we go, it's like this. But they said, it's the single, Bill O'Reilly said it, but many people said it's the single greatest political phenomena they've ever seen. I said, wait a minute, you're wrong. If I don't win on November 8th, I will consider this the single greatest waste of time, energy, and money of anything I've ever done. Because we're not going to be able to reduce your taxes. We're not going to be able to save your Second Amendment, appoint Supreme Court judges, take care of your vets, fix up your depleted, very depleted, our, the greatest people on earth, but our military is so depleted. We're going to take care of a lot of things, including getting the drugs out. A vote for Hillary is a vote for more reckless foreign invasions. What a mess. Does she go down as the all-time worst? More Wall Street cheating, more terrible trade deals, and as WikiLeaks showed, she wants to cut your Medicare and Social Security benefits. You didn't see that. See? And I'm not going to. The press doesn't report that she wants to cut your Social Security and she wants to cut your Medicare. And one of the big advantages of me having a rather large microphone, meaning a lot of people are listening, is that I can talk about WikiLeaks, and look, it's on all the television networks live. We're live. Amazing. Boom, boom, boom. I think they're just turning them all off now. Watch. You go home, they'll say, why did it end so abruptly? A vote for Trump is a vote for America first, and it's a vote to protect Medicare and Social Security and lower your taxes. Big, big tax decrease. We're going to lower your taxes. WikiLeaks also shows something I have been warning about for a very, very long time. The media is simply an extension of the Clinton campaign. It's one of the biggest ways that our system is rigged. And I was the first one to use that term when I was running in the primaries, when I won Louisiana, and I got fewer delegates than people that I beat easily. And my people said, oh, no, that's the way the system works. I said, well, then the system's wrong. How do you win a state and you get less delegates? And I said, this system is rigged. And it was, but we figured out how to win, right? That's what you need. Won in a landslide. Got more votes than anybody in the history of the Republican Party in the primary system. By far. Wasn't even close. Reporters who work for these outlets like the Washington Post or the New York Times, may think of themselves as journalists, but they're actually cogs for a corrupt political machine. That's the Clinton machine. The emails show the New York Times, the Boston Globe, Univision, who I sued. I sued Univision, and I was very happy with what they did. And this lightweight, you know, John Harwood, this lightweight, this guy who came out, he was shaking, he was so nervous, he asked me the first question, Mr. Trump, could you answer this question? What a lightweight. They should have fired him for what he did. John Harwood, I hate to make him famous, but because nobody ever heard of him before, but a total lightweight of CNBC, all doing favors for the Clintons, and reporters smothering the Clintons with praise. The New York Times even gave Clinton a call to give her veto power over her quotes in a story that was already written. Nobody ever called me and said, hi, Mr. Trump, we wrote a story. Would you read the story and please give us a little feedback? Would you like us to take anything out? This system is so rigged. Now, this is all down in the emails. She had veto power over what she said. I'll tell you what, I want to have that too. I want to have veto power. I used to get such good publicity, folks. Now, I mean, it's like, it's incredible. I used to get, my life was so simple. My life was so simple. I had a beautiful, simple life. It was going, I built an unbelievable company. And then I decided to do this, and my life became slightly more complex. You know, we have people in this audience right now that 18 years ago had one great job. They were making more money 18 years ago than they're making now. And now they have two and sometimes three jobs. In other words, they're older and they're working harder and they're making less. Not a good assemblage of facts. Here's the only good news. I'm also older and working harder than I've ever worked before, okay? That I can tell you. Including being in this wonderful arena at 114 degrees temperature. Which is great, because you go home and you lose weight. I mean, why you can't be? You go home, you say, I feel great, I lost a lot of weight. By the way, let Hillary Clinton stand up here for an hour and talk the way I talk, and let's see how long she lasts, folks. What a joke. What a total joke. Our country's in such trouble. That's why it's just so ridiculous. The corporate media can't report on the establishment because the corporate media is the establishment, such a big part of it. We're going to break up the special interest monopoly, and we're going to win this country back for the American people. We're going to do it, too. The emails also reveal that Hillary Clinton believes in global governments, unlimited immigration, unlimited, much more than Obama. From the Middle East, come right in, come right in. 550% more than President Obama, who is grossly incompetent. He doesn't know what the hell he's doing. And why is he campaigning? We just had a horrible jobs report. We have no growth. You saw GDP at 1%. We have no growth. We have a horrible jobs report. China is ripping us off. Japan is ripping us off with the cars. Mexico has an unbelievable deal with us, both on the border. I mean, look at our trade deficit with Mexico and China and Vietnam and everybody. Last year, our country had a trade deficit of almost $800 billion. $800 billion. Who the hell negotiates these deals? I mean, can you believe it? So I say, why the hell is Obama allowed to campaign for Hillary Clinton? He's always campaigning. And he's doing his little thing, you know, having a good time. He ought to be out in the White House. He's not there long. He ought to be there working and fixing some of these horrible trade deals and bringing jobs back to our country, not campaigning for a crooked person, for a totally dishonest and crooked person. Speaking in secret to a foreign bank, Hillary Clinton said, my dream is a hemisphere of common market, that's not good for your jobs, with totally open trade and open borders. 600 million people could pour into the United States. You'll have nothing left. Tell you, if that happens, I know the real estate here. I love the real estate here. Sell fast. Behind closed doors, when she thought no one was listening, she pledged to dissolve the borders of the United States of America. This all came out. She said she wants to dissolve the borders. And here I am saying we want strong borders. We don't want drugs coming in. We don't want crime coming in. I don't know. Maybe I'm wasting my time. Am I wasting my time? I don't think so. She doesn't want to have any borders. Total amnesty. Tell you what, folks, this is the last time you'll ever have a chance to save our country. It's not going to happen anymore. You won't be able. The numbers will be too great. Already, the Republican nominee has a massive disadvantage. And especially when you have the leaders not putting their weight behind the people. They're not putting their weight behind the people. Instead of calling me and saying, congratulations, you did a great job. You absolutely destroyed her in the debate, like everybody said. You know, Pat Buchanan wrote the big article today. You saw it. He said, I'm not bragging. I'm just saying, maybe a little bit, but here. He said it was the single greatest debate performance in the history of presidential politics. So, wouldn't you think that Paul Ryan would call and say, good going? In front of just about the largest audience for a second night debate in the history of the country. So, you know, you'd think that they'd say, great going, Don. Let's go. Let's beat this crook. She's a crook. Let's beat her. We got to stop it. No, he doesn't do that. There's a whole deal going on there. So, I mean, you know, there's a whole deal going on. We're going to figure it out. I always figure things out. But there's a whole sinister deal going on. Crooked Hillary wants to end forever the American independence that our founders gave us. Our great founders are spinning in their graves. Our founders are spinning in their graves. Like Douglas MacArthur, like George Patton, like our generals, they're spinning in their grave. And by the way, General Flynn and all the generals, over 200 admirals and generals have endorsed Donald Trump. 200. Over 200. 21 Congressional Medal of Honor recipients have endorsed Donald Trump. I'll tell you, you know what I like? They're very smart, tough people like me. I like that. The smart, tough people, they like Trump. American soldiers have fought and died to win and keep America's freedom, and now Hillary Clinton wants to surrender that freedom to open borders, open trade, and world government. And I do believe in free trade, but I believe more in smart trade. We're going to make great deals with other countries. We're going to bring jobs back. We're going to bring jobs back. I'm not running to be president of the world. I'm running to be president of the United States of America. I wish those cameras would turn so sometime our friends back in New York and back in Pennsylvania and back in Ohio and all these different states, they could see the crowds. But they do hear it. You know, when you hear the noise, they say they never show the crowd, but you hear the crowd. You can't imitate that noise. We will never surrender the freedom and sovereignty of the United States. It's going to be America first, America first, America first. And yesterday, Hillary had Al Gore, climate change. Now, I want, just so you know, do you know that I've won numerous environmental awards? I'm a believer in the environment. It's got to be within reason. I'm a believer. Here's what I want, though. I want immaculately clean water, and I want immaculately clean air. That's what I want. That's called climate change. That's called environmental protection. But Hillary had this deal, very, very lightly attended. And I watched on television as they said, this is the largest crowd that she's had. You know what? She's got like a tiny little fraction. Now, they're not going to say, look at the crowd. But with crooked Hillary yesterday, she had Al Gore get up. This poor guy, I don't know what the hell happened to him. What happened to him? She had Al Gore get up because, don't forget, Obama thinks that climate change is the single biggest and most dangerous problem for the world today. Not nuclear weapons in the hands of maniacs or in the hands of countries that hate us. No, no, that's no problem. Climate change is our problem. I'll tell you how this is going, how we're doing, folks. If we don't win this election, I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't know. No, no. Can you imagine? Here's a guy where we have ISIS that he essentially founded, if you look. Remember I said founded and he's going to get the medal for having, and not kiddingly. But it's really not that kiddingly. But then they put it on, oh, he found it. I says, let me tell you something. When they pulled out of Iraq the way that we should have never been in Iraq, and I was against it, and they know it. But we should have never been in Iraq. But when we were, the way he pulled out, he announced when he's leaving, he pulled out everybody instead of leaving groups behind. And they created a vacuum, and ISIS was formed. Now, think of this, because the biggest thing that came out of the debate, in my opinion, and it really came out of the first debate, which if I didn't have a fixed microphone or a broken microphone, nobody's been able to tell me, but I watched. Couldn't talk very good because my mic didn't work. But I watched and I said, you know, it's interesting. Hillary says she's going to do this and this and this and this, but she's been there for 30 years. She never did it. And I said to her in the second debate, I said, let me ask you a question. And by the way, you know that so-called commission on presidential debates? The head guy used to work for Bill Clinton. Did you know that? I just found that out. The head guy worked for Bill Clinton. Ay, 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 what a rigged deal this is. But here's the story. I have no respect for that group, by the way. I have none. It sounds good. Presidential Commission, give me a break. That's why I was so happy what we did to annihilate the enemy the other day. So happy. Because we're dealing against a very dishonest system. But Hillary, so important, wants to have a radical, and this is really radical, immigration. She wants to radicalize immigration, where you have people pouring in. Remember this, the Border Patrol agent, 16,500, gave me their endorsement. Last week, ICE, these are great people. You don't hear great things because they're not allowed to do their job. These are people that, frankly, would work a lot less. I mean, their job's easier if Hillary wins because basically all they have to do is stand there and watch people walk in front of them. ICE, these are great people, tough people, smart people. First time in their history, they endorse me. They got to work harder. And they endorse me. And one of the things they told me that I thought was terrible is that she refused, when she was Secretary of State, to make foreign countries take back their criminal aliens. In other words, we have somebody in from a foreign country, illegally. The person kills somebody, hurts somebody, robs a store, robs a bank, does all sorts of, sells drugs all over the place, poisons are used. And we want to send them back to the country from which they came. And they bring them back, and the country says, we're not taking them, because they're smart, they don't want them. So they bring them back into the United States, and we put them into our society. I guarantee you, and you can mark my words, and there's a lot of tape running, that won't happen once when Donald Trump is president. Not once. Guarantee you that. One convicted criminal alien, she allowed to go free, totally free, killed a young girl named Casey Chadwick, beautiful young girl. The corrupt establishment in Washington wants to surrender America's borders, even as they send our troops overseas to protect the borders of other countries. She'll protect those borders, but not our borders. Casey Chadwick was a great example. And he was let free. And she should be alive today. Jamil Shaw has a son, had a son, a great young man, killed violently. And I don't know if you know, but killed violently by an illegal immigrant, shot three times in the face for no reason. Somebody that wasn't supposed to be here. And you have case after case after case. We're not going to have it anymore. We're not going to be the stupid people anymore. We're not going to be the stupid, weak people anymore. A Trump administration will secure, control, defend, and protect the borders of the United States as sure as you are standing here today. We will 100% build the wall. 100%. Are you ready? Are you ready? And who is going to pay for the wall? 100%. They just don't know it yet. They don't know it yet, but 100%. They'll pay for the wall. Hey, look, we're going to have a great relationship with Mexico and China and all of these countries that are ripping us off and now have no respect. They're going to make less, and they're going to like us more. Funny how that works, but it's true. Mexico is making a fortune with trade. They're taking our jobs, so many things. They're going to respect us finally. We will stop the drugs from pouring into our country. Florida has seen a 470% increase in heroin deaths. Think of that. Think if you have a child. 470% increase in heroin deaths since 2007. Think of that. Think of your kids and your grandkids. We're going to stop it. And most of it's coming across the southern border. And let me tell you, when we allow ICE and when we allow the Border Patrol agents and when we give them that big, beautiful wall with a door in it so people can come in, but they have to come in legally. We want them to come in, but they have to come in legally. We will stop the drugs from poisoning our youth and others. But I have a message for the drug dealers, for the gang members and the criminal cartels. Your days are numbered. Believe me, your days are numbered. Hillary also wants a 550% increase in Syrian refugees. We don't know anything about them. This, even though she admitted in private, according to WikiLeaks, just out, that she knows terrorists are trying to infiltrate, and she knows it. They're trying to infiltrate our refugee program. So she said it just yesterday, that she knows they're trying to come in through that method, and yet she wants 550% more than even Obama's staggeringly high numbers, thousands and thousands. We can't let it happen. And you know, we all have a heart, and we'll build safe havens, and we'll have the Gulf states pay because they're not doing their share. Believe me, they're not. They have plenty of money they'll pay. We can't pay. We owe $20 trillion, $20 trillion, doubled during Obama years, doubled. He doubled the debt during his years. In fact, the terrorists have already infiltrated our country. There are now 1,000 open ISIS investigations in our 50 states, a record. Attack after attack, including the recent terrorist strikes in New Jersey, New York, Minnesota, as well as the mall shooting in Washington, were made possible by our extremely open immigration system that's meant only to protect fools, and we're not fools. So let me state this clearly as I can. I am going to keep radical Islamic terrorists the hell out of our country. She won't even use the word. She won't even use the term. Our incompetent president, I call him our campaign president, our incompetent president won't use the term radical Islamic terrorism. He won't use it. He tries to explain it. He spends hours trying to explain why. If you don't identify your problem, folks, you're never going to get rid of it. It's only getting worse. And remember, I said it before. We started off when he became president with no ISIS. Nobody heard the term ISIS, which he calls ISIL. Right? You know why he does that? Because he likes disturbing all of you. He calls ISIL. But we started off, we had no ISIS. And now, 7.5 years later, they're in, they think, 32 countries, and she's going to get rid of them? I can tell you this. They are hoping and they are praying. They are hoping and praying that Hillary Clinton becomes president of the United States, because they'll take over not only that part of the world, they'll take over this country, they'll take over this part of the world. Believe me, they are hoping. They are hoping. And by the way, you know, she likes to say they want me. I will be their worst nightmare. I'm going to be their worst nightmare. Oh. And she lied during the debate. Remember when I said the red line in the sand, right? She said, I wasn't Secretary of State then, all flustered, all crazy. She was there when they drew the line. I walked out, they said, you know, she was there. I said, oh, well, she sort of said she wasn't. She was there. It turned out to be a lie. And even the media said it, they hated. She lied about that. She lied about many things. She put Iran on the path to nuclear weapons. You know this horrible Iran deal where they gave $400 million in cash, but it turned out to be $1.7 billion in cash. You couldn't fit that in the back of this arena. That's how much money it is. They gave that much money to the terrorists, to our enemies. And by the way, our enemies aren't even nice to us. Now they're emboldened. You see the little boats going around our beautiful ships, doing all sorts of little things to drive our people crazy. Folks, they're not going to do that stuff when I'm president, I guarantee you. You see the way they captured our 10 sailors because they were a little bit in the wrong waters? And instead of saying nicely, hey, listen, you got to be over there a little bit, they humiliated the sailors, humiliated their families, and humiliated our country, right? And the only reason they let them go is that our payments of $150 billion started the next day. So stupid they're not. And when they fly, they flew right alongside of our planes the other day. You saw that? They're jet fighters. Right? You saw that? And when Putin is buzzing, you know, Hillary's tough with Russia. You ever notice? Anything that goes wrong, they blame Russia. Russia did it. They have no idea. We're being hacked because we have people that don't know what they're doing. They have people, but they always blame Russia. And then they say, Donald Trump is friends with Putin. I don't know Putin, folks, I promise. I don't know Putin. What the hell do I have to do with Putin? These people are professional con people. They're con. And this country can't have it. This country can't have it. And by the way, Russia, which is buzzing our ships, right? You know, tough Hillary, tough Obama. They're buzzing. You saw that 2 weeks ago, buzzing planes going by. They took over. Yeah, they took over. You look at Ukraine. They took over during, that was Crimea. They took that over during Obama's reign. You know, tough Obama. He's so tough. He's so tough. So look, we need competence, and we need it fast. Hillary Clinton, who turned Libya into a nightmare. How about Libya? How about Benghazi? How about Benghazi, where Ambassador Stevens sent 600 different form messages to Hillary Clinton, and she didn't even respond. The only one she spoke to was that sleaze, Sidney Blumenthal, her friend, who Obama told her you cannot deal with, and she did behind Obama's back. A Trump administration will stop the reckless interventions and instead focus on defeating and totally destroying ISIS. We're also going to build up our cyber defenses. Cyber is a big thing. And keep our power grid and our vital infrastructure modern and safe. And the word keep is an incorrect word because we have to rebuild it. It's a mess. It's so old, it's falling apart. And we're going to use cyber offense to disrupt the enemy where we need to and keep them from recruiting online. ISIS is taking our children and taking our kids out of our country because they're using the internet better than we know how to use it. And we're the ones that came up with it. At the same time, we're going to completely rebuild our very depleted military. We're going to take care of our people. And that includes building state-of-the-art systems of all kinds. When it comes to keeping America safe, I believe in three very important words. Peace through strength. We don't want to use the military, but it's got to be there. And just in closing, to be strong, our country has to be rich again. We're a debtor nation. We're poor. I'm going to make America rich again. My enemy, hey, our enemies are unbelievable. They love what's happening to our country. They love it. Our energy proposals will unlock the $50 trillion in energy reserves right here in America under our feet. This means new jobs in Florida and many, many other communities. Pennsylvania, Ohio, we're going to take care of our miners. We're going to take care of our steel workers. We're going to take care of natural gas. We're going to have clean coal. We're going to also have all forms of advanced energy. We also have to repeal and replace, and we will do this, and it's so important because it's driving everybody and small businesses and big businesses and our country out of business. Repeal and replace Obamacare. Bill Clinton, in a rare moment of truth-telling, said last week Obamacare was a crazy system where people wind up with their premiums doubled and their coverage cut in half. What kind of a system is this? Oh, did he suffer that evening? He went home, poor Bill. He suffered. You see, the next day he came back and he said he was only kidding. He was only kidding. It's a disaster. Obamacare, you know, your rates are going up 68%. In Texas, they had 71%. In other communities, they're going to go 95 and 100%. And next year is going to be worse. We have no choice but to absolutely repeal, replace Obamacare. And we're going to come up with a much better plan for much less money. As you know, also, most counties in the state will only have one insurer to choose from. Obama does that because that way they have a monopoly so they can charge you whatever the hell they want. This is our chance to stop the abusive and horrible and something that doesn't work, Obamacare, and save American health care. But you have to get out and vote. At the center of our economic revival will be fixing our terrible trade deals. When I announced, seems like a long time now, June 16th, coming down with Melania, the escalator, remember in Trump Tower, that was an amazing thing. And we announced that it was a big part. And then I came out and I said, Florida and our countries, we have all of these lost jobs, all of our lost manufacturing. We're going to get it back. We're bringing our jobs back. When countries come in and think they're going to steal our companies, and our companies are going to go out and fire all of their employees in Florida, in Ohio, in Pennsylvania, in all of these countries, all of these, everyone, we are not going to allow it to happen. We are not going to allow it. We are going to tell it, you are going to have consequences. The states are not going to put up with it anymore. Our federal government is going to help. We've built other countries at our expense. We have. So if they come in like they did in Indiana, where Mike Pence, by the way, is doing a great job, it's great. And they take, in the case, they take Mexico, takes Carrier Air Conditioning, and they fire their 1,400 people who were so great to me. And they think they're going to make air conditioners in their beautiful new plant in Mexico and sell them across the border and make lots of money, and we have all the unemployment. Not going to happen. We're going to put a 35% tax on, and they're staying in the United States. And if they don't, we're going to make plenty of money. We are going to rebuild our country. Our country is going to be a country where you can be proud of again. We're going to use American steel. We're going to use American labor. We are going to come first in all deals. We're not going to make the trade deal where we come in fifth and sixth and seventh and other countries laugh at our stupidity. We are going to build great companies. We are going to expand companies that are now doing poorly. We are going to make our country very rich again. We are going to make our country very safe again. We are going to make America strong again. And we are going to make America great again. God bless you, everybody. God bless you. Thank you.